today the corporations are not organized and don't have the tools to merge the petrotechnical decision with the economics decision. This is typically two things completely separate. I have a campaign about a few whales. I have booked my rig, and suddenly, just as we saw a few months ago, there's a crash. Economics conditions change completely. How will that affect my power of actually drilling those wells? Will I even be able to make it on a profitable way? Should I just cancel everything? Is it better for me to cancel everything, not do this campaign, fall and wait for the things to be better? Or should I continue? Should I do 3 wells, 5 wells, 10 wells? Most operators have been faced with that particular question over the last few months. And for them, it is a struggle because this is not a decision that one person can make. It's a decision that typically you have the reservoir management, the financial people, the capital planning, the portfolio management, the drilling engineer, the production engineer, the asset manager, all those people who are typically in different organizations in the same corporation have to work together, typically sequentially, in order to make that complex decision. It takes them weeks. By that time, money has been spent or money has not been spent, and things cannot be unspent if they have been spent. If it was too bad, if it was the wrong decision, that's too late. It's been done already. And so how can you accelerate that decision making? How can you make it such that, well, if something changes somewhere along the food chain, well, you input that change, and that triggers all the applications, and all the people know what they have to do, and they see that change, they do their own part, and then they can make the decision together.
Well, the oil and gas industry faces many challenges. It's not getting any less risky. In fact, it's getting more uncertain. And a lot of this uncertainty comes from the fact that we're shifting away from the well-by-well type of decision-making that we saw in the conventional oil and gas industry, and moving to more of these large mega-projects that we now find that are characterized as unconventional industries. I characterize them as large integrated projects, and they're the sum of many, many individual decisions, and every decision has an impact on a course that someone might take in the future. And so with this level of integration, we have to be incorporating a lot more different potential scenarios. We have to incorporate a lot more different internal and external influences on the project. And we're effectively marrying the surface level risk with the subsurface risk. And we're really looking to make sure that we have a balance between those perspectives. And this is a very different way of thinking of things, where people typically were looking for a single or deterministic number to make their decision on. We're now seeing people think more in ranges, more in uncertainties, and when you combine these together, you get an ability to not only manage your expectations in terms of reward, but you can manage your expectations in terms of the risk that you bring on. Now, this type of thinking, which I call expected value thinking, is quite different. It requires companies to approach their planning processes in a different way. You have to go away from your time-driven annual planning cycle and move to more of a cycle where it's more iterative, more collaborative, and where you're planning at will or when the decision is required. And you're seeking to do that on good data, timely data, and having systems that provide that information to you when it's needed.
We've been in the market for on economics for quite a while with Landmark. We are the market leader with Aris in North America. But what we do is really reserve calculation at the well level. It's quite complicated in the US because of the property management, the way the government and the different partners, etc., all take their shares, and the many owners between wells and lands and etc. So all those calculations can be quite complex, and they are orchestrated by regulation, by the SEC and other things, but it's still limited workflow. If you ask some people in the street what is economics, they will not think about economics as being what I just described. They will think about something bigger, and this is truly what we want to do. We want to move away from the limited economics we were doing, which was very important workflow, very critical workflow, business critical workflow for most corporations, but still a limited workflow, to something much larger, which is really decision-making based on finance and economics criteria.
What's really exciting to me about the Landmark Palantir Alliance is that it originally started out as really the connection of two technical platforms, where we would take the Landmark decision space and connect it to the Palantir planning space and make it much more easy to move data across the platforms and share certain functionalities between the applications. As we began to look at this fusion of these two worlds, the subsurface world with the surface world, or the technical world with the commercial world, we began to understand that there was many more opportunities to create completely different solutions that and workflows that move between the two different spaces. And this enabled us to come up with solutions that we think are going to save companies hours and days of analytical time and enable them to do completely different planning processes that are much more iterative and much more responsive to changes in market conditions. And we ultimately see that the asset, with their technical experience and their understanding of the options available to that asset, will provide an enormous number of scenarios to the corporate planners who will be able to make really rich, robust portfolio plans based on that information, and ultimately design business plans that are much more resilient and capable of operating in a wider range of commercial and market conditions. And it really, we're looking at this as being a competitive advantage for those companies that adopt these types of tools and processes. It's really exciting, and I think it's something that's definitely needed in the industry going forward.